हेलो फ्रेंड, वेलकम टू माय चैनल 5 मिनट पीडियाटिक। फ्यू डेज बैक आई हैव पोस्टेड टू क्वेश्चन रिलेटेड टू डायरिया विथ पेरियोनल, डायरिया प्लस पेरियनल एक्सकोरिएशन। सो लेट डिस्कस टू डिजीज वन बाय वन। सो फर्स्ट क्वेश्चन वाज 7 मंथ ओल्ड चाइल्ड with chronic diarrhea and skin lesion, which was distributed symmetrically over perianal, perioral and acral area. So this is typical history of acrodermatitis intropathica. Now, next question, if we look here also, we have 7 month child came with multiple episode of loose stool with abdominal distension. There is also perianal excoriation. Mother also told that the child passed stool with sound. Okay. And stool for reducing substance was positive. So this is the typical history of lactose intolerance. Okay, so let's discuss acrodermatitis intropathica. So it is an autosomal recessive condition. In intestine, there is defective absorption of zinc as there is mutation in zinc transporter protein. Okay, it usually occur a child with chronic diarrhea or child with chronic malabsorption syndrome, or a child on prolonged TPN. Okay, here the child present with vesicobullous, dry, scaly lesion, which is symmetrically distributed over, this is perioral area and perineal area. Okay, while in case of lactose intolerance, you get only excoriation over perineal area. Okay, if you look at this, the child is having alopecia with a specific reddish tint. Okay, the child have poor wound healing. You may get the child having growth retardation. Okay. And if you go for the investigation, you may find the serum zinc level less than 50 microgram per deciliter and alkaline phosphatase is decreased. Okay. The treatment of this condition, we have to give zinc a little bit at higher dose, that is 3 milligram per kg per day. So this is all about acrodermatitis intropathica. Next we have lactose intolerance. Okay, it is of two type. Okay, first one is primary. There is congenital absence of lactase enzyme, and other we have secondary. This is more common, secondary lactose intolerance. This is more common. Okay, what happens in this condition? In intestinal, there is microvilli. Destruction of this microvilli leads to temporary loss of lactase enzyme. So after stopping source of lactose, this again regenerate and the condition subsides. So this is lactose secondary lactose intolerance, while primary there is a congenital absence, so you have to give lactose free milk along with lactase enzyme. Okay, in this condition, in lactose intolerance, always a child comes with a stable condition, pass a small stool, pass a stool with after just feed, and there is sore bottom, that is perianal excoriation. This occurs due to acidic stool. So if you get perianal excoriation only, think of lactose intolerance. You may get support by positive reducing substance in stool. Okay. Hope so you enjoyed this video. Kindly like, subscribe, and follow my channel. I am available on Facebook and YouTube. Thank you. Thank you for watching.